This was found adhered to your lungs. Intact. A petal. White Star of Bethlehem. The hospital. Skullface sent you to Cyprus to kill Snake. You were burned inside and out. That should have been the end of it. But, all things considered, you look pretty damn healthy to me. We have Skullface to thank for that, right?
I was the only one capable of applying them to parasite therapy. Until he stole them from me.
Why are you here? Did Skullface send you? Or did you have your own score to settle with the boss?
Oh, better... whatever.
Refreshing? Salt water.
No! She'll die!
His life isn't yours to take. Enough.
That's enough.
If she wanted to kill the boss, he'd already be dead. Same goes for us. Had plenty of chances. She can't talk. She's not here to kill anyone. You're wasting your time. It doesn't matter why she's here. She works for you now. She's in love with the legend.
What makes you so sure?
I was the same way once.
What if she's a spy?
What if I'm a spy?
Are you?
Go on all day.
Boss,
let her go. She won't speak so she can't spread the infection.
Seems like what's happening is they're just throwing in random stuff to wrap up everybody's, all these characters' side stories. This is wrapping up Quiet's. The one before was Huey's or whatever. That seems like what's going on.
Nah, but get that dish.
Oh, neat.
Let's not get them tea.
Oh.
EDG block on it, eh?
Oh. Akko kode jiste sni.
The bizarre.
Elagana gesnita. Katobe yasteta. Asetota. Dotonista.
She has big teeth. But yeah, that seems like what's going on. They're just wrapping up everybody's storyline. Cinematics. Lazy. Stupid Konami for being assholes. Okay.
Boss, I've updated the mission list. We've received some new job offers. The details are on your iDroid. Boss,
please select a
mission. Some of the kids we've been keeping here have escaped. We don't know why they ran off, but it may have something to do with Ralph's death. The intel team's looking for them as we speak. I'll add information to your side ops list as it comes in. You need to locate and secure those kids. I'll try to find out what happened.
Okay. Oh my god.
Please select a landing zone. Landing zone.
It's so frustrating that it doesn't let you in here. Dude. First I need this, obviously. I'm trying to think. Kids, we'll do the other mission. Hopefully we don't have to do all those. And we could just get number 41 unlocked. Beat the game. So dragging it the hell out.
Mission list.
Boss, I've updated the mission list. We've received some new job offers. The details are on your iDroid. Boss, some of the kids we've been keeping here have escaped.
Please stop talking.
Don't know why they ran off, but it may have something to do with Ralph's death. The intel team's looking for them as we speak. I'll add information to your side ops list as it comes in. You need to locate and secure those kids. I'll try to find out what happened.
Boss, we gave Ralph, that kid who died in the accident, a burial at sea. The man in charge of that facility has been severely punished.
Mm-hmm.
But ever since, the kids have been acting strange. It's obvious they've lost their trust in adults. I was getting reports of them ignoring the staff, or getting insolent, and even violent. And a few days later, several of the kids did a disappearing act. They snuck into choppers and shipping containers and got off base. Why? Your guess is as good as mine. These kids were born in a war zone. And forced to grow up as war fighters. If they're left alone, war is how they'll die. But I thought we showed them there are other reasons to live. I never liked having children on Mother Base. But the thought of them going back to the battlefield and picking up their old lifestyle is something I can't stomach. It makes me think of Chico, 9 years ago.
Boy, Chico.
We have to get those kids back. Hell, they know too much about our operation. I never expected even the kids to betray us.
Yeah, it sucks. Alright.
Please select a land heading to Central Africa. Deploying.
Oh, I have the rocket launcher. Well, whatever. May need it. I don't really use the sniper rifle anyway. Because it's not silenced. So it's poopy. Poopy poopy. But all I need is this pistol. Good to go. Wish I upgraded it for to have the piercing shots so I can still clap on kids with armor. What are you gonna do? Pretty much. Oh, the oil field. Alright.
Be careful down there, boss.
And there's a helicopter. Ugh. Well, hopefully Dee Dee will spot him quickly.
Enemy presence
can always shoot that helicopter down if it pisses me off too much.
Enemy detected. The map has been updated.
Boss, you need to find those kids who escaped. Fighting's still the only way of life they know. If we don't bring them back, they'll just end up getting killed. Boss, if we develop a child-sized Fulton recovery device, you'll be able to extract those kids. Send the development order from your iDroid if you need it.
Can I make one of those?
Please specify a project.
Tools can be used on animals. Oh, children. 36 minutes. I don't have that kind of time. D-Dog, I should be able to find the kids no problem. Let me extract this before that vehicle gets too close. Oh, these have chains on them, so means I can't go through, obviously. Okay. If nothing, we can count on boss respecting your boundaries. This. Get the fuck out of the way. Ruining everything. Just put him here. That's fine. Just get him out of here. Goddamn thing about it. Just need to get far enough away out of the helicopter's path. Okay, so that's one kid. It's one of the Chirins.
Please select a support helicopter.
Roger.
Requested.
Uh-oh. landmines and shit. Should blow that fucking thing up. Get out of the beam? It's a little hard to do because he's constantly on my shit. You know what? I am gonna blow this fucking thing up. Piece of garbage. Watch out! Oh, you got a wolf. Oh, did I pick up the kid? Pick up the fucking kid! Quad, just chill for a second. God, all the way over there, you couldn't park any closer, you fucking tool. I guess what I'll do is park my the Jeep. That's done. Oh my god.
Please select landing zone.
Roger.
Support helicopter requested.
I'm just gonna tell him to drive me there. I'm not gonna. About to say, where's my go-to? That was fairly simple. So one kid each should be okay, hopefully. I should have got in. I thought there were more kids. Should have got in. Shit. No, it's just a waste of time. These guys making shadow puppets?
Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
This is B-Quad. Arriving shortly at LZ.
I'm waiting for you, bud. Done. I just want to finish it. might need to get up and walk around for a second. All locked down.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
Snake, you remember the White Mamba? Of course, he's been going by Eli since we brought him on base. He was the leader of the child soldier unit we took out of that village and into our protection. Well, according to the kids you brought back here, all the escapees were especially close to Eli. There's reason to suspect he's behind all six escapes. We've already detained him. I'll be questioning him shortly.
Wait. You'll be?
Ocelot.
You're incapable of taking an impartial stance with those kids. Question them all you want. It'll get you nowhere.
Ocelot, you get too many kicks from your art of interrogation.
It's not a matter of art. It's about quick, minimal strokes of psychological warfare. That's what gets the answers. And it's the best way to keep both questioner and subject safe. The risks only increase the more an interrogation drags on. At that point, it causes as much pain to the inflictor as the inflicted.
Like I said, too many kicks.
Huh. What I'm trying to tell you is we need quick results. Otherwise, it'll be too little, too late.
I know that.
And besides, I know the subject. I won't go overboard with a kid.
Forget it. You're not needed. Snake, we'll want to question the other kids too. Be sure to bring them all back.
Sounds like there's just two. I hope. Stop saying all.
Please select a mission.
Yeah, these are all. These are all other older missions. That's really dumb how that is now the main.
Please select
the main poopy. It is the main poopy. Okay.
Deploying.
Horse Doggy. Straight goats.
Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated.
This way. Oh, damn it.
Enemy presence detected. Has been updated.
Oh, the mansion.
According to the intel team, the escape kids should be around here. Locate and secure them.
Boss, if we develop a child-sized Fulton recovery device, you'll be able to extract those kids. Send a development order from your iDroid if you need it.
Flipping out. There we go. Behind the sleeping guard. Got you in the foot. Or the leg, rather. You too. Yeah, please walk out into the open. And then sleepy time. Sleepy time times two. And then before this truck gets here, snatch. Snatch. Duck. Don't be mean to the dog. He's trying to be your friend. That's not a guy, that's a thing. D-Dog's already marked all the guys. Should know better. Take down Princess.
The map has been updated.
Cool. Ladder, please. There we go.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Okay. I believe this is the way I went last time. But at some point I just had to start sprinting because I got caught. Or seat. Found out. However you want to say it. Yeah, this should be right to where I need to go, actually. Oh, shit. Nope, that's to a bunch of dudes, is where that goes. Well, you know what? There, 1, 2, 3. This guy's gonna be a bitch. This guy's also gonna be a bitch, but he's down. Also down. Fine. Also down. Come on. Down. Hide for a bit. That's whatever is going on with that guy is weird. Don't shoot the dog if that's what you're doing. Okay, you're being a bitch. Fuck your knife. All I gotta do is spam right trigger. God! How? Fuck that guy. Where did he come from? God damn it! I was almost done tranking all those assholes. Better not start from way out here. Alright. They're going fast.
According to the intel team, the escaped kids should be around here. Locate and secure them. Boss, if we develop a child-sized Fulton recovery device, you'll be able to extract those kids. Send the development order from your iDroid if you need it.
That's really frustrating how even though I know that's not a guy, he's gonna keep locking onto it, you fucking asshole. Here's piece of shit, waste of a bullet and my goddamn dart or suppressor.
Development complete.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Shoot. No. Fuck you. And we're done playing nice now. No. That's a serious.
Boss, what happened? Boss!
Okay. Should just equip the chicken hat, because I don't want to fucking... I might just do it next time, because this is... No, this is just repeat filler.
According to the intel team, the escaped kids should be around here. Locate and secure them. Boss, if we develop a child-sized Volt recovery device, you'll be able to extract those kids. Send the development order from your iDroid if you need it.
Come on. Come on. Shit.
Please select a support helicopter.
Roger.
Requested.
Take that. So this mission, the next one, God, this is
extraction arrived at mother base.
Annoying at this point. We're getting there. We are getting there.
This is B-Quad. Arriving shortly at LZ.
So just these two dickhead kids, huh?
This is B-Quad. Have arrived at LZ.
Shut up, B-Quad. I don't know how it just auto-fultoned the kit out, even though I didn't have it made yet. Maybe it did, I don't know.
Enemy prison detected. The map has been cleared.
Okay, they still didn't wake up yet. Fuckers. Should have gone in there and started blasting either way.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
Snake, about the escaped children. Eli confessed. The way he tells it, they wanted to go back to the battlefield. Don't rob them of their freedom, he said. If you bring them all back, there will be consequences. Next, to be asking for our surrender.
Consequences? What consequences?
No idea. That's all I have for now.
You're too attached to those kids. Stop protecting Eli.
Listen to yourself.
Let me question him, and we'll get some real answers.
Not necessary. I'll report as and when.
Okay, do your thing.
Please select a mission. Mission accepted. Heading to Afghanistan.
We're back to the main missions. Sure. And these are all good.
Deploying.
Excuse me, in my throat again, as usual. Always acting up and pissing me off.
Boss, retrieve the film canister our informant hid in Spoogmate Keep before he died. It contains vital information on Skullface's plan. For now, our only clue is the garbled photograph the informant tried to send us before the end. We're working on analyzing the data, but there's no time to wait. A KGB Spetsnaz squad is after the target as well. Boss, go to Spoogmate Keep and use the VI to lead you to where the film canister is hidden. It is paramount you retrieve the target before the end does.
Okay. Spoogmate Keep. I don't know if I've ever been here, so this might be something new. Man, wish I could talk that I've cleared my throat every couple seconds. Cover the stuff in the thing. Got it.
Enemy cruiser detected. The map has been updated. You have arrived at your destination.
These are the KGB fucks. Or Spetsnaz fucks. Or whatever. Whatever and whoever. I wish I could just see around this corner. Nope. Armor on? I think so. Come on, fuck you. Damn it. Get up.
Dead.
Come on, then you're fucking. You wanted to go. Well, you got it. It's impossible, guys. Fuck.
Snake, are you okay? Snake!
Go to Spook Mate Keep and use the VI to lead you to where the film canister is hidden. It is paramount you retrieve the target before the enemy does.
I don't know what the VI is.
Enemy presence detected. The map, you have arrived at your destination.
Friend is hurt, you don't come help him? You get the same. Position is here. Fuck. Get dunked. Okay. Find the thing. You're dead as well. Come in, Dimitri One, what's wrong? What's wrong is that guy's dead. Now what am I doing? Dude, no. Get crapped on. As a matter of fact here. Get these guys out of here. I don't need them coming back up. This out of here. Alright.
He's coming too. Roger that.
Oh, these idiots. Sorry, gentlemen, but we're just trying to beat the game and you're in the way. Normally I wouldn't do this. Okay. So what exactly am I looking for? Film canister. That's not gonna do it, that's biodetector. Said use the VI to find where it is, but that doesn't help at all. Here's a mouse. I don't know what the VI is. Tell you what the VI is. Virtual. No, I don't know. Virtual intelligence is all I can think of. so we're going to look it up. Let's see. Okay, so I have to look at a picture of my iDroid somewhere. Oh, there it is. This picture is not good that they give you. Like, there it is on the bottom, like what? I can't even fully look at it because the fucking mission tasks are cutting it off.
Boss, we fully decrypted the VI data.
Cool.
Now the target's hiding place should be clear as day. Check your iDroid.
Document added? Where is that? Archway beneath a crack. This. I'm gonna order this.
You've completed your objective. Now get out of the hot zone.
Mission inventory has been updated.
Ain't no hot zone because everyone's dead. Guess I can just go directly where I came from. I'll take this car, because the other one should just get automatically fultoned out.
Extraction arrived at mother base.
Neato. And just go this way and hot zone left.
Alright, you're out of the hot zone. No enemy forces in pursuit. Mission complete.
Yeah. See the talks here spoken up.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base. Development project has been added.
Cool.
Mission complete. Great work.
Hamburgers, don't give a fuck. Did we beat the game? No.
Side ops list updated.
Boss, I have a quick report for you here. We've discovered a radiation leak in the laboratory on the quarantine platform. It's coming from testing equipment we installed the other day. Members of the medical team have been conducting research there. But we'll evacuate them all from the research block to the containment block next to it. Emmerich.
There's no need to worry. No radioactive material is leaked, so the contamination won't spread. We just need to seal off the testing equipment.
I've dispatched a security team to get the researchers out. I'll keep you updated.
Damn it. At least I can use the Fulton to get him out now. Once I do this, I might be done playing this game for today. Should have been done for good. Or should I just... I should just power through this shit. Fucking stupid cliff gonna make me run all the way? Fine. Piece of shit. Actually, no, we're not doing that. It's gonna take forever.
Please select a support helicopter.
Roger.
Requested.
I should just really am getting tired of it for sure, though. But I'll just beat it. Rescue three kids, do all this bullshit, all this side crap that has nothing to do with the actual story. It's just wrapping up the, story, all these side characters. Quiet's is done, Emmerich's is done, now we just need these stupid kids and see the cutscene where Eli gets in the Metal Gear and like Snake yells in a corridor that's on fire, so whatever.
Good dog.
But hey, man, my back hurts just sitting playing games.
This is Pequot, arriving shortly at LZ. This is Pequot, on station at LZ.
Okay. Go now. Go ahead.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
White. My God.
We finished decoding the informant's report. That floating kid we've run into a few times now. Looks like he was a test subject in clinical experiments. The Soviets called him the Third Boy. The Third Boy was brought to a lab on the outskirts of Moscow from Czechoslovakia, after which he was due to be sent to a research center in Leningrad, then Siberia, and finally an academic town in Novosibirsk. It doesn't appear that the researchers witnessed the talents we've seen from him, but nevertheless, he was quite the popular subject. His latent cognitive abilities suddenly awoke en route to Moscow. According to the report, the Third Boy was easily influenced by other individuals' biofields. Evil thoughts, in particular. They affected his mind like a virus. Extreme anger or resentment, motives for revenge, in other words. Now, during the transport flight to Moscow, the boy was exposed to a powerful mental energy field coming from a certain individual. Ever since, being conscious of his powers, he's become a sort of energy generator. What's unique about him is the way his acute telepathic abilities get taken over by another person's will. The boy began to physically parasitize individuals experiencing extreme anger and codify the host's desires. This includes amplifying the host's natural strengths. Or, in accordance with the host's desires, he can also implant program code in another individual, making them a puppet, essentially. Human neural synapses transmit weak electrical currents between neurons. These electrical currents, though at a level difficult to observe, warp the magnetic field outside the body. The Third Boy is able to pick up these weak fluctuations. Contrary to psychotronics, which involves controlling the human mind, his abilities as a receptor are too high. The emotions he picks up from another individual are amplified and unleashed into his body as they recur in his brain. They turn into microwaves, which then affect the physical world, triggering paranormal phenomena like the spontaneous combustion of organic matter or psychokinesis, moving an object without touching it. There's one other thing. While he's parasitizing a host, the boy's ego gets shut away, allowing the will of the host to take control of his powers, like some annoying static drowning out your own voice. That means he isn't responsible for what's been happening. Somebody's extreme anger has manifested through the Third Boy's powers in ways none of us could have predicted. which would mean this was going on somewhere around us. Looking back on it, a lot of things make sense now.
Do they?
The man on fire saw Lanthropus. They both came to life thanks to the third boy's powers. Everything has been happening through him as a catalyst. We first saw him in the hospital on Cyprus. The boy parasitizing the man on fire's desire for revenge gave him his new abilities in return. He next appeared at the Hamid Fighter's Fort where the honeybee was hidden. There, the boy parasitized Skullface's vengeful mind. He controlled Sahelanthropus, making it do whatever Skullface wanted. Same goes for when we extracted Emmerich onto the chopper. When he appeared at the Devil's House in Central Africa, Skullface's will controlled the man on fire via the third boy's powers. Everything is clear up to this point. But even the informant couldn't pinpoint who the host was in the cave within Serac Power Plant. Sahelanthropus suddenly became active, then crushed not only the man on fire, but Skullface as well. Surely neither of them could have been the host. Who else was at that location and bore anger more extreme than either of them? Whose will was controlling Sahelanthropus? According to the report, emotions transmitted in children's brains affect the surrounding magnetic field more strongly. Cerebral nerves are covered with insulation called myelin sheaths.
Jesus Christ.
Pulse speed. The reason for this leakage has to do with the fact that children's myelin sheaths are still developing. So, how many children do you remember being there? Children with a burning desire for revenge and bearing a grudge against you. I can think of only one. Eli. We don't know what kind of life he's had, but the resentment he's shown toward adults is nothing short of extraordinary. The third boy resonated with Eli's mind. And that means Eli bore the strongest animosity of all individuals within the boy's reception range, estimated to be a 3-mile radius, beating out even Volgan and Skullface. The third boy has probably remained hooked on Eli's anger since. You remember at the Devil's House, the third boy showed an interest in Shabani? That must have been his ego making a rare appearance. He may possess abilities far beyond anyone else in the world, but he's still a kid. Maybe them both being kids was enough to bring them together. And if so, maybe with Eli, he isn't feeding off him, but acting in symbiosis with him. So what kickstarted the third boy's powers?
Jesus.
If we look at the location and time that his plane went down, we can make a pretty good guess. When the plane experienced the first anomaly, it gave an accurate report of its position to a control tower. Due north of the Black Sea, 125 miles east of Kiev. Dead south on the Black Sea is Cyprus's Green Line. So the plane's position was directly north of the hospital where you'd been asleep for 9 years. And this anomaly was reported at exactly the same time that you woke up. The plane was enveloped in flame from the inside out. The fuselage burnt to ashes. There were no survivors, at least not publicly admitted. Your thoughts formed a synchronicity with the boy's psyche and were amplified inside his brain. That would have been more than enough to trigger his abilities. Your rage was like a big bang in his head, blowing the lid off his powers. The boy was then secretly moved to the lab outside of Moscow where Volgan was comatose. There, Volgan's thoughts resonated with the boy and he was awakened. Volgan became the man on fire, hell-bent on getting revenge on you. His instincts led him straight to you. Skullface knew Volgan from Operation Snake Eater, or perhaps from even before. Monitoring this pair of extraordinaries, he discovered the hospital and sent his assassin and XOF. Skullface was probably watching the situation from close by. Then, realizing how useful these two test subjects could be, he approached them. Reacting to Skullface's thirst for revenge, this time the boy let Skullface's will control Volgan. Volgan, at times driven by personal revenge, at times through Skullface's will, kept on moving, though his body was little more than dead meat. Perhaps there were moments where even your thoughts affected him as well. But without the boy's power, it was like the plug had been pulled from the socket. Everything was powered by anger